For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I doubt that September 23 will be the last day of the world. The Bible says that no man knoweth the times. And yet you get a perverter, a deceiver, trying to deceive the people. I will tell you what the Bible says. Death is coming. It may happen now, it may happen this afternoon. It may happen tomorrow, a week, a month, a year. And what you do today will rest assured your eternity and hereafter. The Bible says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Nothing else. I nor anybody can tell you when the end of the world is going to be. We cannot give you the date of the rapture, but I can tell you right now, without Jesus Christ, you will go to hell. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. God is not willing that any should perish. The long suffering of God and the patience and holiness of God is that he sends those that are his children with a King James Bible to tell you what you must do. In preparation for heaven is not a religion. It is not generators. It's not the fear of Planet X. It is the fear of God, which bringeth wisdom and the knowledge of the Holy. I don't want you to fear, think the world's going to end tomorrow. But I want you to fear the fact is that you may die today, end up in hell for all eternity. That whenever you do die, and if you die without Jesus Christ, you will burn in the devil's hell forever. And you will not get out. For God so loved the world. The love of God is Jesus Christ. There is nothing else in the eyes and in the plan and the will of God for a man to be saved but by the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. God has already wrought your salvation. The Bible says it is a gift of God. And by a gift of God, you've got to receive it. You've got to believe with thy heart. God is Jesus, and Jesus is God. And according to Acts 20:28, that blood that was spilt upon Calvary is God's blood. And the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world is wrought by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. For Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. You don't come to God with religion. You don't come to God with works. You don't proclaim that you're a good person. You don't bring cash. You bring the precious blood of Christ without spot. That is the means for one to be saved. Without Jesus Christ, there is no heaven. There is no access to God without Jesus Christ. We come here because you may get a foolish notion or idea that there is no God. That you are okay in your religion. And you can clean Mother Earth. But you cannot cleanse your soul of sin. And without Jesus Christ, you will end in the realm of Mother Earth of flames and fire forever. Peter tells us that this planet will engulf itself in flame and fervent heat. And without the salvation brought of God by God, Jesus Christ, your afterlife will be the lake of fire that burns forever. Without Jesus Christ, there's no hope. There is no peace, saith God unto the wicked. You cannot be right with God the Father without Jesus Christ the Son. And when you put on a man's grave that rejected Jesus Christ, R.I.P., or rest in peace, you are lying. There is no peace, saith the Lord, unto the wicked. And when you reject Jesus Christ and his gift, my God, the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God, eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. When you reject that gift, in the eyes of God, in the holiness of God, you are wicked. But preacher, I don't care what you have not, I don't care what you have. If you have rejected Jesus Christ as your Savior,
how many people
you are wicked.
You chase away by doing it. You chase a lot of people away because I'll tell you what, I'd never go to your church.
Wow, I see a lot of people running.
I believe in God, Jesus, but what you're doing is wrong.
Okay. Pick up the Bible and read it. For God so loved the world. The love of God is through Jesus Christ alone. And yeah, people will run away by the masses. The Bible already said it. But the Bible also says, go in all the world and preach the gospel. I don't care what you do with it. I'm preaching the gospel that you may know what God expects from you. That's all I can do. Is preach. Believing or rejecting, that's on your hand. But you have heard. You are without excuse. when you'll stand before God that you rejected and say, I never knew. And yet you have heard the love of God is Jesus Christ, and you must believe on Him to be saved. You heard. It's so simple to be saved. Anybody can do it with a heart. And yet, salvation by Jesus Christ alone will set for you a peaceful, a hopeful afterlife. Now, if you trust Christ today or tomorrow, Lord willing, I am not going to promise you you're going to have a good life on this planet. But I will tell you, it will change your destination. Through Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world, it will take you out of hell and put you before God in heaven. The Bible says that those that are saved are already seated in heavenly places. Your body just has not made it. The Bible says upon the death of a believer to be absent from the body and present with the Lord. I'm a believer of God and Jesus Christ, but I hate what you're doing. You need to check your salvation. Because God says in Romans chapter 10 that He loves the feet that preach the gospel of peace. The gospel is that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures. And was buried. And arose again the third day, according to the scriptures. That's the gospel. And the peace is if you were to believe on Jesus Christ, you would go to heaven. The condemnation is if you're to continue to reject Jesus Christ. You're not going to hell, you're already there. John chapter 3. He that believeth on Him is not condemned. But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not believed the name of the only begotten Son of God. He that believeth on the Son has everlasting life. He that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. The wrath of God is hell, the lake of fire. By the loving God that sent Jesus Christ. God is love. You probably couldn't find that in the pages of the Bible if I told you what book to look in. And yet God is also holy and righteous. And God hates sin as well as the sinner. Nowhere can you find in the pages of the Bible God loving a sinner in his sins. Sodom and Gomorrah were destroyed because of their sins, including the people. Judah was destroyed because of the sin and the people. Tyrus, destroyed because of the sin and the people. Babylon, destroyed because of the sin and the people. America, that will be destroyed because of the sin, and you Americans that's due to sinning. I do not see the pages of the Bible, new heaven, new earth, and God bless America. There are no Americans in heaven. There are no Americans in hell. Heaven is by those that have received Christ as their Savior. Hell, by those that reject the Savior, Jesus Christ. You go to heaven by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. Faith with your heart and believe. You go to hell by anything you want to do outside Jesus Christ. Religion is the perfect way to hell. And atheism is a religion. You believe there's no God. Religion is in belief. And when your time has come to die, where will you be settled? Salvation is wrought by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. There is salvation in no other but the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. You cannot approach God and say, look how good I am, when the Bible says there are none good. No, not one. Romans chapter 3. For all have sinned. All have come short of the glory of God. And without Jesus Christ as your Savior, expect the worst of the worst of the worstest pain ever to be cast out into the lake of fire that burns forever with no relief and no pain. And you do not have to go there. By the Jesus of the Bible, if you were to confess Jesus Christ as your Savior and be washed in the blood of Jesus Christ for your sins, thou shalt be saved. You bring your repentance to God the Son upon Calvary's hill. You come with a repentant heart, wanting to get right with God. And God in no wise will not cast you out. You come to Calvary to get right with God, God will beat you to Calvary first. You must believe on the Son to be saved. It must be in Jesus. Whatever you tag to your entrance to heaven, if it's not Jesus Christ, you are not going to heaven. According to the Bible. you will surely suffer the wrath of God without Jesus. And you will surely be blessed by believing and putting your faith on Jesus Christ as your Savior. You must be born again. Without Jesus Christ, you are not right in the eyes of God.